I guess I will just try not to die. That's my plan.
Active shooter situations have riddled the country with fear, and many people question the right way to prepare if something like this were to happen near them.
In our freshman seminar class, we saw an instruction video on how not to die during an active shooter situation.
Stanisław Zajeja, an international student from Poland, is grasping this as a new concept.
I don't think we even have a phrase for like a school shooting, but we know that it happens here in the States.
Gun shop owner Kemlin Hart believes that giving people the ability to carry a firearm could help prevent a mass shooting.
The gun might be the first guy he runs into might stop the threat. So I'm very much for having the ability to carry. You don't have to, but having the ability, I think, is an essential need.
But as a professor at Waldorf University, David Dam is unsettled by the idea.
I would prefer not to be armed. To me, more guns means more potential for trouble.
Jason Raymaker, Waldorf University's Dean of Students, works with a team to make sure Waldorf is as prepared as it can be.
The first thing is we have policies that are called emergency response plans.
These plans can be found on Waldorf University's website under Campus Safety. Detailed instructions are laid out for students to educate themselves.
What to do in different types of situations, whether you would run or hide or barricade, because each situation is different. You don't know if you're going to be in a library, a residence hall, out in the open.
Raymaker believes being aware of your surroundings and the mental health of those around you should be your number one concern.
As a small campus, I think that puts us at an advantage that we know each other a little bit better. We're a little bit more aware of what's normal, what's not.
I don't think that anybody can be really fully prepared for an active shooter situation.
Danica Cheney, Wall TV News.